Welcome to the National Center on Intensive Intervention's video demonstration of how to use its lesson plans for families. In this short video, we demonstrate how one family is using a teacher-selected lesson plan to provide multiplication and division practice at home. The video features Connor, a third-grade student, working with his grandpa at the kitchen table. Prior to the lesson, the teacher modeled how to access and use the lessons at home. She demonstrated that the lessons are found under the Intervention Materials tab on the NCII website and can be accessed by clicking on the Mathematics in the pull-down menu. She explained that Connor's data indicated that he needs additional practice in multiplication and division in order to make progress towards his learning goals. As a result, she selected lessons available for that skill. While she emailed a copy of the lesson plan directly to Connor's grandpa, she also showed him where to access the video demonstrations of how to model the skills and where to find additional activities and worksheets, as well as the lesson plan booklet. She reviewed the lesson plan structure, including clarifying what materials were needed, the importance of modeling the skill, and how to provide corrective feedback if Connor made any errors during the lesson. Let's watch as Connor participates in a multiplication lesson delivered by his grandpa at home.
All right, your grandmother and mom left us by ourselves, so, and your teacher sent us this assignment, and so we're going to do it. Multiplication. You know what that is?
Yeah.
Okay. So what it says that we need, let me turn this off before we get started so we're not interrupted. All right, so it says we need flashcards, so I made flashcards ahead of time. Need the worksheet. I've got the worksheet. The objective is for you to actually learn multiplication. And then it said small paper plates, but I didn't have a paper plate, so I'm just going to use this paper here. All right, so let's start out with one of these multiplications here. Ah, here's a good one. 3 times 5. So if I was going to try to figure out what 3 times 5 is, it kind of made me a drawing. Let me get a piece of paper here. So if I got 3 friends and I want to give them, let's say, 5 pieces of candy, I have 1, 2, 3. That's my friends. So I'm going to give them a candy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so now I've got my 3 friends. I've given them each 5 pieces of candy. So by drawing this, I can figure out how much 3 times 5 is. So I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So 3 times 5 should be 15. So turn my card over, sure enough, it's 15. All right, so let me get one here for you to do. Let's do 3 times 6. And you do the same thing. Now let's do a 4. Let's do a 4 times 5.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Very good. Now that's a variation from what I did. I would have did, you know, 4 times 5, but you did 5 times 4. So good. So how many is it?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Okay, so 4 times 5 should be 20. Very good. So that, how easy is that?
Easy.
Very good. All right, so let's do one more. Let's do...
Okay.
65 times 6?
So?
You got 5 friends, you're going to give them 6 pieces of candy.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Now, you didn't quite do that right because it's 5 times 6. You have 5 friends, but you also gave them 5 pieces of candy. You're going to give them 6 pieces of candy.
6, 6, 6, 6, 6.
Okay.
So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30.
Very good. So 5 times 6 should be 30.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Thank
good
you.
Job.
Did you notice how Connor's grandpa used materials available around the house to deliver the lesson? In this next video, watch as he uses playing cards to deliver the second activity in order to teach division.
All right, you did really well with the multiplications. So now we're going to go into division. Let's see, the teacher says we need flashcards, which I made ahead of time. I got the worksheet right here. And the objective is for you to learn how to divide. I need small paper plates, but I didn't have any, so we're going to use this paper. And I'm going to use mainly these cards on mine, okay? So let's see what the, I'll demonstrate the first one. Okay, let's use this 12 objects. Let me find 12 objects. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Now I want to give these 12 objects to 4 of my friends. So how am I going to get to each one? Well, I got to figure that out. So I'm going to make 4 stacks. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So by looking at this now, I've got 12 objects. I put them in 4 stacks, which I've divided by 4. And it'll tell me 1, 2, 3. So 12 divided by 4 should be 3. I'm going to give each one of them 3. See how simple that is? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give a different one, and you're going to do it. Let's see, so we've got 12 here. Need to add 6 to that, so we'll have 18. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so I've got 18 cards. Yeah, 18 cards, and you want to give it to 6 friends. How many are they going to get? How many is each friend going to get?
They
figure it out with the cards. How many cards is each friend going to get?
3.
Very good. So we got 18 divided by 6?
3.
All right. So let's do a different one here. 15. Gotta make sure we got 15 cards. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. All right, so you got 15 cards, and this time you've only got 3 friends. So how many cards are you going to get?
5.
So 15 divided by 3 is 5. Excellent.
Yeah.
So you understand now how to divide cards up, mm-hmm. or any kind of object with the number of people, mm-hmm. or the number that goes with it.
Yes, sir.
Very good.